is my genius hour quarter four project. My thick question is, how can I teach my classmates about different breeds of beef cattle and their purposes? Why is this project worthwhile to me and impact? This project is worthwhile to me because I like to farm and I like to learn about cows. This will impact others because it will teach them about the cows around this area. Steps. Thought of a thick question, then I researched on the thick question. Picked the breeds I was going to use, made a PowerPoint, and now presenting. So Fleckfeeds came to America in 1968. They were bred for milk, beef, and draft. People nowadays want this breed because they produce lots of milk and have good beef production. In the U.S., people look for carcass quality cavities with depth of rib and natural thickness. First Charolais came to the U.S. in 1934. Good for growth ability, efficient feedlot gains, carcass cutout values, muscling, correctness, and size. Angus came to America in 1873. Good because few calving problems. The black skin reduces eye problems. Also, no sunburn or snowburn udders. Traits that can make a real difference in a cow herd profitability. Low maintenance. Adaptable, maternal instincts, super milking capabilities, and high fertility rates. Red Angus came to America in 1883. They were resistant to harsh weather, undemanding, adaptable, good nurtured. They are early maturing, have a high carcass yield with nice marbling, are used widely in crossbreeding, improving carcass quality and milking ability. Cavanese, people like them more than Black Angus because they are calmer. Hereford, they are the better breeders than many other breeds, quiet, gentle. They don't need as good of food to live. Adaptable to wide range of climates, easier handling, high cut meat, and excellent maternal qualities. Limousine, ability to thrive damp winters and odd hot spelling in summer. Calving very easily, high immune system. Illnesses are rarely found in these cattle. Many farmers praise the limousine breed for its efficient in converting feed to weight. Popular sires for dairy farmers, these carcasses have up to 8% meat yield in some carcasses. Good marbling quality making for great tenderness. Galvey, triple purpose cattle, efficient for daughter work, milking production and beef production, primarily used in the beef industry. Galvey cattle have dark hooves and strongly pigmented skin. This helps keep the sun damage to a minimum. They're resistant to ticks and parasites. Begin puberty earlier than many other breeds of cattle, have strong maternal instincts. Udders are ideal for nurturing calves with good quality milk. Calving is a relatively unproblematic process for the Galvey cows now. Galvey carcasses have great cutout yields. One study has proven that the breed has the largest ribeye muscle area per 100 kilograms. Of all beef breeds, the breed gains weight at an efficient rate and their meat is lean and tender.
Remember where your audience is.
Shorthorn. Dairy shorthorn and beef shorthorn. Dams have well-developed mothering instincts. Calving is fairly easy for the breed, with over 95% of the births need no assistance whatsoever. cows can breed again in a relatively short time compared to other breeds. Heifers reach puberty earlier. Shorthorns have good disease resistance and immune systems. The cattle are naturally grazed and convert feed to beef and milk with great efficiency. A lot of people use this breed to show. Lowest cost per 100 of milk. These cattle were well liked for efficient weight gain and suitable for low input. More information on shorthorns. A lot of people use, okay, lowest feed cost per 100 of milk, the lowest total dry matter intake per 100 weight of body weight. These cattle are well liked for their efficient weight gain and shorthorn beef nicely marbled, adding to its tenderness, and the average yield of carcass is about 60.5%. They also finish quite early, which is an advantage to farmers wishing to produce in a short instance period. Summary. I do this because I like to learn about cattle and what to be a farmer when I grow up, so I need to know about cows, and also because these are the cattle in this area where we live. And these are my sources.